Hey everyone, it's John, and it is not Dry Fire Monday today, but it is Live Fire Monday, sponsored by the Mantis X Firearms Performance System. I have a tip for you today about recoil control, and I'm going to show it to you today. It's the reason that we're out on the range today. It's really hard to show this in dry fire. So we're on the live fire range today. I'm going to show you about using your forearms as the primary agent in your recoil control. Whether in dry fire or in live fire, the Mantis X Firearms training system really helps you to get better every day with your defensive shooting. I use mine all the time. So today I'm out here at the range at C2 Tactical in Scottsdale, and I just want to say thanks to C2 for allowing me to have some space this morning to do some videos. Really appreciate that. Fantastic facility, by the way, and I'm a member here, and they just let me in a little early so it's not loud. Today we're going to work on recoil control. And I said something in our live fire class in Kansas that caused a couple of the better shooters to go, really, John? So I want to show you, and so you can work on it your next live fire session. Now, I can show you the targets if you want. The targets on this particular drill are completely irrelevant, and you can use your Mantis here to actually give you some objective feedback on what's happening. What I'm trying to show you here is that a lot of people, when they get this gun out here, they lock their elbows and they drive their arms all the way out. And you see this on the presentation, they go whoop, doing, and the gun comes all the way out here. And notice my left elbow here, I'm left-handed, so I've put you over on that side so you can see my primary hand, is locked all the way out. And what happens when you do that, and I'm gonna show you this in live fire in just a second, is now I've made this what Scott Jedlinski calls a 2x4, right? So instead of, I have no recoil control here. So all the impulse from the gun, my hands are gonna control the muzzle flip, but the rest of the recoil impulse is gonna go through my forearm, through my elbow directly, through my upper arm, into my shoulders. Now, if I drive my shoulders forward, then the shoulder muscles will act as my first and primary recoil control mechanism, but that's gonna push me back as well, because it's gonna have to push through my body, and eventually I have to transfer all that force down to the earth, and so I'm gonna get it through my feet. Now, there's a couple ways that you can combat this. We see a lot of times people get, I'm gonna move over here, I'm gonna back over this way a little bit, is what people get is a kind of tactical turtle. They kind of stick their butt out this way, and so then they drive this way, and when they push their arms out straight, now it pushes through the shoulders, through your butt, and it's a little bit easier. Okay, that is a method that you can do. However, that does a couple of other things. It makes it difficult on your posture. And the fastest competitive shooters, and of course, when it's time as defensive shooters, I'm a defensive shooter, probably like you are, but when it comes time to shoot somebody, we are now in a shooting problem. So as a defensive shooter, I want to shoot fast and accurate. Therefore, I'm going to learn from the best shooters when it's time to do the shooting thing, right? So not when it's time to do the tactics thing. We're just talking about pure shooting right now. So I really want to drive that gun straight up in front of me. I don't want to duck my head. I don't want to do all that stuff. We've got other videos on that. But I want to see here, here's what happens. Now, if I drive my elbows straight out like this, what happens is again, I got to go this way. But if I give my elbows just a little bit of bend, not a ton, I'm not talking about this, we're not doing this thing, pew, 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 that's kind of weird, right? But if I give my elbows just a little bit of bend, now how much bend am I talking? Not much. Well, listen, now this acts as well as another shock absorber. Yes, it's gonna transfer energy, but it's gonna transfer it through instead my elbows as a shock absorber. And think about this on your car, right? That's what Scott Jedlinski, who's my shooting coach, okay? So that's why I talk about Scott. Talk about if you put 2x4s in place of your shocks on your car, the car would obviously go bang, 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 because it's transferring any change in the road into the cab. Whereas if you put shock absorbers there, something that can move, then it will dampen that. And that means less movement of your body. Less movement of your body means less movement of your head. It means you can see better. And at an intermediate to advanced level, you can shoot as fast as you can see. So I recorded a little bit earlier a few shots. And one of the things that I think that the Mantis X is really good at here is it can show me what my muzzle is doing after the shot goes off and in that 200 milliseconds after. So I'll put some screenshots up there of kind of what it showed in a couple. What I did was drove my elbows out and locked them tight, did a couple of shots with that, then gave just a little bit of bend and gave a couple of shots with that. But here's what I want you to see. So I'm not, no unnecessary tension. I'm not messing around with things, okay? I'm not trying to have confirmation bias just to prove my point. What I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to just get after it, okay? So grateful, thankful to MagTech for ammo. They're our ammo sponsor, really grateful to them as well. Okay, shooting Benvolio, my P30, still testing this shield RMS. So let's hold off on all those questions, okay? So What I'm going to do here first is I just want to make sure that I can see it here. I'm using my phone to record. So what I want you to watch here is I want you to watch, number one, the motion of my body. I'm going to step out here so you can see it a little bit. But I want you to watch what my body does, right? and what happens here as I bring the gun up, elbows are locked out. Just watch the recoil impulse and what that does to me. Now, you notice that my body is going just a little bit. Now, all I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna add just the tiniest bit of bend in my elbows. Just the tiniest bit. Not a ton. Now, here's what I noticed right away. Now, I can tell you this from the perspective, and you're gonna have to see this, okay? And I'm gonna see if I can actually show you. I don't know that I'll be able to, but I'm gonna try on the camera. Is that when I am locked out like this, when I'm locked all the way out, what happens to my red dot? And I, as a red dot shooter, it gives me more feedback, okay? So you could see this on irons, it's a little easier if you're a dot shooter. That when my elbows are locked all the way out here and I take a shot, what happens is that my dot leaves the window and then comes back fairly quick. But if I have just a little bit of bend in my elbows, not a ton, just a little bit of bend, my dot never leaves the window. So I can shoot fast and accurate because my dot never leaves the window, so I see it more frequently. So here's something for you to work on your next live fire iteration. And that is to see that dot, or if you're not using a dot, see your front sight, do all those things and feel the difference between your elbows locked out and just a little bit of bend to allow them to be a bit of a shock absorber. See how it helps you your next live fire session. So I'm just gonna show you this on the black backstop because it works a little better. See if I can get it to work. So I'm gonna press my arms all the way out. Can you see the dot there? If I press my arms all the way out and let you see that, I'm just gonna let you see what the dot does. That's about what it does. And you can see it leave the window and then come back. Now, I'm gonna bring that in and just provide the tiniest bit of bend in my elbows. Basically same thing, just tiniest bit of bend in my elbows. Do you notice that the dot has never left the window? That's what I'm talking about.